23 minutes past the hour. Fans are remembering Dustin Diamond, who played Screech on Saved by the Bell.
Mm-mm. Bad idea, sir. Last year, those Valley pranksters stole it.
Well, what do you suggest?
Let me hide it, sir. I'll find a secret place where no one will find it.
Really? Where?
If I tell you, it won't be a secret. Duh.
Well, the actor died yesterday at the age of 44, just a few weeks after revealing that he was diagnosed with cancer. Oncologist Dr. David Spigel is the chief scientific officer at the Sarah Cannon Research Institute, and that's in Nashville. You know, doctor, he died apparently of a type of lung cancer only 3 weeks after learning he had it. Is that out of character or very much in line with this type of cancer?
Good morning, Robin. I was sorry to hear about that, and my thoughts are with his family and friends. So what I've been able to learn, it's a type of lung cancer that's not as common as some others. We call it small cell lung cancer. We see this in about 25% of patients who are diagnosed with lung cancer. So one in four have this type. Unfortunately, this type, like a lot of cancers, tends to be discovered when it's already spread. It's not true for everybody. And I suspect here, and it's just a guess, that this wasn't found till it had already spread, and that makes it much, much more difficult to treat.
Yeah, his manager, I think, remarked that he only went in after dealing with a lump on his throat and feeling out of sorts, is how it was described. Is it common to have a cancer but not actually have symptoms that you feel in the organ in which it originated?
Yeah, it's a great question, and it's one of the scary things about any kind of health problem is, you know, when is something, you know, you should worry about and bring to the attention of your doctor. In the case of lung cancer can show itself in so many ways that are common, especially now during this awful pandemic, but a cough, shortness of breath, certainly weight loss or pain, or as you say, a lump. As always, you know, if something's out of the ordinary of concern that's persisting, seek medical attention. Fortunately, these days, we now have screening for lung cancer, much like for colon cancer and breast cancer prevention. Finding cancer earlier with colonoscopies or mammography in those examples. We now know for patients who are at risk for lung cancer, so those who have heavy smoking histories, can get CT scans on an annual basis to try to find these sorts of problems earlier where you can improve the chances that they'll beat it.
You know, different accounts say that Diamond insisted that in the past that he was not a smoker. But isn't that the biggest risk factor, or are there others?
Yeah, that's what's a little bit odd about this. And again, I hate sometimes commenting. I hate always commenting on anybody's health condition without knowing the details. But it's true. If you have small cell lung cancer, it always goes with smoking. And so, you know, when you look back, it's very unusual to find a patient who suffers from small cell lung cancer, who doesn't have a history of smoking. Again, I don't know if that's a primary exposure in this case or secondary exposure, but usually those things are linked.
Yeah. So sorry to hear about Dustin Diamond's passing. Is there anything on the forefront, either in development or research, that you're aware of that is promising to loved ones and families who have somebody who is suffering from this type of cancer?
Yeah, I think so. I mean, we certainly in Georgia, where you are, in Tennessee, where I am, we tend to see a lot of this because of the association with smoking. And we've always had great options in terms of therapy called chemotherapy that can help control cancer like this, but never good enough to keep it away for long periods of time, unfortunately. But there have been some breakthroughs in the last few years, specifically something we've talked about on this program before, something called immune therapy. So using medicine to get your body's own immune system to fight cancer, and in small cell lung cancer, there have been great strides made where we now have two therapies available for treatment in addition to chemotherapy. So real advances and more hopefully coming.
His team says he did not suffer and did not have to be in pain for a long period of time. So they are grateful for that, grateful to hear that. I'm grateful to you, Dr. Spigel, for your information and joining us today. Thank you.
Thank you.